In Indian automotive industry, one of the major strength is Indian engineers. We have very young and talented engineers are there. These engineers also are very good at learning. They have the ability to learn new things which are there. So these are one of the major strengths in Indian automotive industry. We are also accustomed to frugal engineering, which is a requirement of the future, because all of us have grown into this kind of Indian atmosphere where we try to find out innovative solutions for lower cost. So these are very great advantages for the Indian automotive industry when we are developing new products. I will also cover what are the lacunae, which are the areas where do we lack, which is there. Definitely there are areas where we lack is discipline. I mean, all of us in India, there is a lack of discipline which is there. The same thing is reflected when we are trying to manage our projects, the project planning, the timeline management, the costs management, etc. So these are the some of the areas where our engineers, our people, our technicians, our designers have to learn from the international designers, international community in vehicle development. Now, if these areas are learnt, I think our engineers will be extremely better in developing the products. They will be comparable to anybody else in the world. So these are some of the areas where we have strengths. Another point which I would bring it out here is we are quite accommodative. We are flexible, we are accommodative, which is a great, because when you are innovating a new product, this kind of flexibility and accommodation is absolutely required. So these are some of the areas where we fare much better, and we'll be doing much better in future. In 2010-11, the auto component export is 26 billion. And there is a really big future for auto component export. Our engineers again are developing components for developed countries, and many of the components are directly going to their production lines. The developed countries have understood the strength in the Indian industry, in the auto component industry, and several new projects are coming to the auto component industry. Whatever the AMP targets were there, our auto component industry has really, they are going to surpass those targets, and there is a bright future for the auto component industry in future. While we are very happy about this development, we also have to look what are the new countries which are coming into the auto component, like the other countries like Malaysia, Thailand, China, of course, all of us know. So we have to really look at how they develop products, and which will be a good learning even for us in future. Innovation is the key word for future. Without innovation, I think we are not going to succeed. And innovation has to percolate right down up to the shop floor. Innovation cannot be just done in design offices and high-tech areas. Innovation has to go right down up to shop floor, where each and every worker starts innovating. Now, innovation is extremely important, because today when we are trying to sell our products in the global market, unless and until we really know how these products are used, how the customers are there, and how we can find out innovative solutions which add a bigger value to the product. So this is absolutely important in future for India to succeed, and these are the areas where a lot of efforts are going on. There are efforts going on in the automotive industry, in the component industry, in the research associations, various research organizations, and innovation is the key word for future. This decade, I think, unless we innovate, unless innovation becomes a daily practice, I don't think we'll be able to succeed. So frugal engineering means actually achieving a particular objective, achieving a particular goal with the lowest of cost which is there. Frugal engineering is not low quality. The quality has to be good. Frugal engineering will consider what are the customer applications, what are the customer demands, what is the, how the particular product is used. And if that particular product has to be designed, how it can be designed in a way where which requires lesser processes, which require lesser material, which requires number of steps when you manufacture, less number of manufacturing of steps. So frugal engineering is all these areas, and I think we have a one product which is Tata Nano, which has been getting attention all over the world, and they have shown really that the same car, which a low cost car, how it can be manufactured with less material and innovative engineering. So this is frugal engineering, which where Indian engineers are accustomed to that, because we have grown in an atmosphere of frugal engineering. Indian future automobile industry, there will be a need where the Indian automobile industry has to work hand in hand with the infrastructure development. As you know, in future, electric mobility and hybrid electric vehicles, they are going to come in the market, and this is where the entire world is paying attention. So when we are talking of electric mobility requires infrastructure. Infrastructure for charging batteries. So this is where infrastructure has to be available all across the cities, all across the country. And building this infrastructure, unless this infrastructure is built properly, the future electric mobility will not be able to work with it. So it is very essential that the automobile engineers, the component engineers and the infrastructure people, they have to come together to chart out a plan for infrastructure development in future, and that will give an impetus to the vehicle mobility, the mobility industry in future. So the APEC Expo is a very good platform for the component industry and for the vehicle manufacturers to showcase their products. All over the world, several delegates are going to come. Almost more than 1,000 delegates will be there in the APEC event. And this is a good platform for the industry to showcase their products, because people will know all over the world what kind of things are available in India, what kind of components are available in India, what kind of products are there, what kind of IT technologies are available in India. So this will be a good platform. Today for APEC Expo, we have got a very good response. We have almost 60 to 65% of the stalls are already booked, and every day they are getting more and more. So the response has been extremely good. And this being the first event of APEC in this country, I think looking at that, the response has been exceptionally good. And I think we are going to really draw a big benefit out of this APEC Expo. So today we have got vehicle manufacturers, we have got component manufacturers, we have got service providers, we have got people from the IT industry who want to showcase their products. And this definitely aligns with the theme of this particular conference, APEC conference, which is there, where they would like to showcase their products to the prospective customers and prospective